Hello and welcome to a special video edition of Scary's Rock Art here in my workshop, otherwise known as my little chamber of horrors. So today we're going to try something a little bit different. I'm not going to be making anything. I'm actually going to be attempting to scrap some electric motors to get the copper inside. Now this isn't something that I've done before. I've seen it being done on YouTube and I understand the principle of it. The principle of it that we want to get the copper out because the copper is valuable. I can also use the copper in these crafts and so on. So I have a couple of tools here. I have a big screwdriver, a couple of different types of pliers, trusty hammer, a metal snips, a power screwdriver, tile cutter, pipe wrench, an electric saw with a metal blade, and this big old hammer drill. I have a chisel attachment for that, and as you can see, it's got a very long drill bit on the end. So we'll see what we can do. The small one here, I have a couple of different engines, motors, to scrap out. The small one we just saw, sorry, everything's a mess as usual. Okay, so this is the small one. My first move is I'm going to cut the shaft off the end there and hopefully be able to crack this apart. I have a little clamp, but I don't think it's going to be very good. The main event is going to be this single phase electric motor. It's seems to be located in some sort of a metal steel casing. Now I'm not interested in any of the other metals. People will talk about scrapping aluminium, scrapping steel and stuff like that. That might change, but right now I'm only interested in getting the copper out, and that's what I'm going to try and do now. So this one has some, try and get this down a little bit more. This one has some bolts holding on each end. I don't know what they do if they hold the casing together, so we're going to have them off anyway and see what happens. Well, that worked. Threaded bolt. So they came out without any major problems. Great, actually easier than I expected. So we'll see what happens now. Seems to be some sort of pin there. I should really have had a look at this motor before I attempted to start dismantling it. Oh, hang on, there's a casing that's starting to move. That's a good sign. Looks like, you see, if I knew my way around these things, I'd probably know what's what. This looks like some sort of a clip. This looks like some sort of a clip that will open. I hope. I tried to sell these motors. These motors have been on sale for well over a year as motors, you know, for anybody who wants to use them as motors. It's not happening, so they haven't been, nobody's been interested in them. So I said, great, I'm not dumping them. I'm going to see what's happening. And also, nothing wrong with a little bit of destruction here. Okay, so this is actually coming apart fairly easily. Just the screwdriver is pulling that off, yeah. I still didn't manage to unclip the clips, which probably would make the whole process easier. There we go, just flew off. Great. Don't know what kind of metal that is, and I don't really care. Don't know what, oh, it's a rubber gasket. I don't care about that either. So it looks like I have to repeat the same procedure on the other side. I'll try this lip slip first. It's very hard. Woo! Sprung right off. It's very hard not to make faces when you're doing the same thing, so please excuse me. There's that rubber gasket thing. Don't know what it is, don't know what it's made of, don't care, I'm not using it. So this is the big flex to attach to. There's the metal bracket. Presumably would have been attached to something. Anyway, let's have a look what's inside. The goodies. See the copper already. What I think I'll do is give this a whack of a hammer. Seems to have largely done the trick. Oh, I can see the copper from here. Very nice. Very nice. Now, the one thing I don't have actually is an angle grinder, and I think that would probably help the situation a lot if I was to get one, but I don't have one right now, so I'll pull this away. Wires keeping that there. It looks like it. Okay, so some wires there that are holding the thing together. Snip them off. Okay. I'm gonna cut this wire off completely. I'm not sure if this is just supposed to spin off under its own steam, like screw on. Feels like there's some kind of glue there. Or do I have to break it off? Either way is fine by me. Okay, so it seems to be glued onto something some way. Okay, that's fine. We'll come back to that. This other one. So that's loose as well. Some kind of a big nut on this. Do I have to break that off? Not sure. That's, I think there's a nut. I see some kind of a brass nut there on that over the shaft. That seems to be keeping these metal casing in place. I guess I could cut it off. Let's see what happens. So that's my Black & Decker Scorpion saw. Seems to have cut through this quite easily. So that comes out. There seems to be still a brass washer there. Obviously the shaft isn't going to just slip through like that, so I have to use some gentle persuasion, I think. We go through this. Bouncing around. Try to tear it off again. It's always the little things that hold you up, but with that big piece of metal was no problem. The saw went through it in 2 seconds. This little brass ring is annoying me. Tiny little ring, and it's holding on for dear life. Okay, I can't come through it, so I just pushed it off. Hopefully that's all it was holding this on. Still seems to be spinning away. So let's see if I can knock it off again. So I don't know my way around these things, so I'm not altogether sure how it's constructed. Okay, it seems to be coming off pretty well. Can it just be pulled off? I can't actually see if there's a nut holding that thing on. It's moving anyway. Probably find this isn't worth all the effort, but a hasher, something different to do. You can see some wires in there. Cut those. starting to get an idea of what this looks like now. It's interesting. It's the first time I've seen one of these motors up close and ripped open, because I've never done this before. And it's obvious that it's going to be a bit of work in extracting the copper. So this lid thing, this part of the motor seems to be moving along. Okay, yeah, just let's see what we can do. I think a vise would be very handy, bench vise. Okay, so I can see our precious copper in there. So I'm just going to go ahead and slice some of it out. I don't necessarily need to take this thing off. I'm going to pour my t-shirt over my thing because I don't have a mask. And I don't really want to get metal dust everywhere, but hey. Okay, let's see what happened there. I didn't think I went through it that easily, so in actual fact I didn't. Seem to have gone through the top layer, but alright. Okay, so back to the saw. Things work better when you have the right equipment, but not me. Okay, so that seems to be, believe it or believe it not, it seems to be coming off. If you look, a great big chunk of that, I've just been able to, I've cut through it and now I've been able to pry it loose. So I need to go cut through another section. Mask again, yeah. Okay, let's put this out of the way. high tech. So, I'm sure there's probably some people looking at me with horror using my legs instead of a workbench, but what can you do? I haven't got a workbench. My legs will grow back. So the doctor tells me, right, so that's been moderately successful, actually. Not sure about all this paper crap that's over it, but for my first recovery, it wasn't a complete disaster. It has about, I'm guessing, in my hand, 1 pound, half a pound maybe, of copper. Let's take all this stuff off. Probably a lot more copper even in an average size copper pipe, but we're doing this for fun as well. So that's about half of it. That's one side of it, one hemisphere of the motor come out with all that. It's okay, I guess. And then there's copper in the little hole. So I know from YouTube videos that they have to be knocked out with a hammer, so just put this to one side. Motor feels much lighter already. Okay, so we'll try the other side now. Hopefully it'll be as easy, if you can call that easy. No, this ain't gonna come out quite as easily because this bit is, I think, fixed. Oh, hang on, it's not fixed. No, it's great. It's the same. Yeah, perfect. Perfect. So what's good for the goose should be good for the gander. Ooh, you can see it. You can see it all in there. All in there, huh? Same. So I'm gonna cut that out. And hopefully we can move on then to knocking the out of the middle. Okay, so I'll put on my mask. about that is the vibrations through that saw from my hand, through my wrist. Horrible. Probably just the way I was holding it. Right. So effectively managed to get copper dust pretty much everywhere. Let's see. Will this come off? Yeah, looks like it. It looks like I didn't cut all the way through. I didn't manage to get all the way through. I got quite a lot of it. Piece there. I remember when we were kids, I mean, there was copper everywhere. Building sites and people used to dump it. You used to find it everywhere. Pipes and hot water tanks. It was everywhere. A couple of people used to bring it to the scrapyard and sell it for scrap. But it was off. Usually, in those days, it was deemed that it wasn't worth it. It wasn't worthwhile. But I've heard how much the price of it is now. Think in euros. 6,000 per ton, I think. Certainly very close to it. So I'm a long way from a ton in copper. This is just, I'm just trying. We'll see what happens. Maybe I'll get a ton quicker than I expect because now I'm looking for it. Made the decision from, oh sure, I won't. If I come across copper, I'll leave it or whatever. I'll think about it, but I'll leave it. But I've gone from there to now I've actively started to look for it in terms of it's lying around or I see it somewhere being thrown out or scrap or whatever. So now that I'm looking for it, I'm making an effort to recover it. So I guess that's the first step. We'll see what happens. Okay, there's actually quite a bit in there. I just need to get it out. I don't know if you can, probably can't see it. Looks like some of the pieces in the middle in the this camera is ridiculous. You see some of the pieces in there are starting to come out, which is good because it means I don't have to go and knock them out with a hammer. Well, I probably do have to do that. Are you feeling yourself? Seen a few videos on YouTube of people recovering copper. Some people are very adept at it. They know what they're doing. They've been doing it for long enough. I'm still kind of hoping that that'll just screw off, but that's not happening. Try it again. It's obviously on some sort of a bearing. These must be the holes for it here. Yeah. I think that's going to happen. So let's see if we can recover our copper from that side, shall we? Yeah. Where's my little pliers? I had a pliers here. Go.